I strongly say that private schools are better because in government schools the teachers have to do so many works, extra works like a part of teaching that are doing census or doing household survey, and they are also engaged in vaccination and
many elections are there.
So they are engaged in doing in election duty and making voter ID cards. So there are so many works for the teachers in the school, and public is also responsible for this because public doesn't send their child regularly to school. So when any child doesn't come in the school regularly, so it affects their its education, and then when he comes in the class, he disturbs only. He can't understand anything, and he disturbs all the class, and it is major problem of the public school. And there is a lack of infrastructure. There are only building which is also not properly built, and there is lack of electricity and other facilities. And on the other hand, we see in the private schools, they are rich in infrastructure. They have enriched lab and computer labs. Computer is the main need of this era, and they are also doing on the personality development of the students, and they are rich in sports activities and sports goods, and there is a proper management who manages the school. And in the government school, there are so many schools, and the government school at primary level, they are at 1 kilometer distance. One primary school is distant to other is only 1 kilometer, and there is not sufficient students, we can say there are a few students in the school.
As you are saying that government schools lack infrastructure, I'll tell you a thing, that you are talking about that 10% private schools, you are comparing with only those 10% schools. If you go in small tier 3, tier 4 cities, in villages, there are also private schools. And they are doing the same thing which are done by the government schools. And the kids are going there, they are going to study, they are studying there. So that's also a problem. And like you have also speak about what?
Let her answer this question.
As you said earlier, that there is a mindset that why we send my child in the government school, I am capable to pay the fee. That is also a mindset, because there are so many private schools in the village areas, in the rural areas. We see that there are teachers which are worse than government. There are government teachers are higher educated, and they are more capable. But it is also the mindset. The people are capable to pay the fee. They send their students, their children to the private school.
In villages there is a status symbol that they call it an English medium school. They hire a graduation pass, 12 pass men or women, their persons, and they are teaching there. They are not that much literate to teach the students, and like they also does not have infrastructure, but people are sending their kids there because that is a private school. That is the mentality where
they just know this is a private school, that's why they are sending.
No. Like on the name of English
on
media.
That's the reason.
If you go and see, like they are not literate.
It's a, It's a status symbol to send their child in the private school, and they go in the van, and the van comes to
kind of facilities they are providing just by seeing it.
Facility is not matter. The matter is that they are, it is a status symbol for.
Oh, status symbol.
They are.
Who wants to say something?
Van is not.
I ask something to both of you. As ma'am used to say, the people want to make their status symbol. Yes, this is a not totally good, but a true. But it's a kind of true. But in my opinion, not everyone want to invest their money on their school. If the government school provided the good education on their on students, and the basic, in my opinion, as he used to say, in private school, many students are not capable. Teachers is not capable to teach. They are done their 10th and 12th or graduation, and they used to teach as a student. Yes, this is true. In government school, as we can say, in current situation, there is a lot of teachers are also join the government school as he cracking after cracking the examination competition. He is totally capable to teach. But actually, how you can see those teachers to do their work? They are do their work
that's,
as honestly.
That's the problem. That's the problem.
As you can say, as you say. The teachers in private school, the teachers doing their work on their student, they provided many in personality developments, they teaching English learning. Why the government is teachers is not capable for that? It is capable.
Teachers are capable for that.
Yes. But why? But why?
Teachers are capable for that. But as I said that the parents are not capable for doing this in the private schools. There are parents in I am saying about urban areas. The private in private schools, parents are very aware of their yes, their education, and they help in their studies. They give them tuition, and they go to school in all the PTMs all the time when they are called, and they help in their studies and doing their homework. But in the government schools, what happens? they throw their bags in their home and go outside to play, and the parents are not interested in.
You are saying that
parents is also responsible.
No, those kids are not interested in studies.
A few students, and who are studying properly, they do.
If this is the responsibility of guardian or parents to
look after. If any parents is sending their kids into the government schools, if a kid is going into the school first time. If the teacher is going to take care of that kid, like teachers take care of that kid in private schools, so the kid will go to the school.
Yes, definitely.
The problem is with the teachers.
Yes, I have told you.
They are not showing that belonging.
They can't do their work honestly. Yes, I agree with them.
That's the problem.
In my school,
ma'am,
why you are not teaching? She's a government teacher.
I put my point. Okay. I have a question.
You are saying that all the teachers
are
90% is a major.
We are not.
It's shameful to.
No, we are not.
I agree with you that. There are so many teachers.
Yes, why we are only stuck to the only teachers.
Ma'am, what you have did to make your school best? You have did anything?
Yes. I go in my school properly and I teach.
You are just going with the trend, like what's going on, what we have to do. You know your job and you are doing the same thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what you are doing. That's the problem.
What can I do?
That's the problem.
What should I do?
A teacher should take initiative. A teacher should take some new decisions, like
and
we are not authorized to take any decisions.
I am not talking about that top level decisions. I am talking about like if a kid is coming into the school, you should
we welcome them. We behave properly. We love them and we take care of them. But
I have seen kids who come back from the school and abuse their teachers. No. The ratio is very low. If you talk about it's 80-20. It's 80-20.
It's a matter of the environment they are having at home.
Yeah.
Not because of school, this school. Because the society they are coming from, that is creating an impact on them.
Yes, sir.
The people who are going in the government school, their fathers are auto rickshaw drivers, anda wala, sabji wala. They don't know how to talk. Every day he goes for work, drinks liquor in the night, comes and beats his wife. He's seeing that. He's seeing a lot of child abuse, and cause of that is becoming like that. We cannot make even students responsible
for
that.
They abuse their parents.
Actually, parents are responsible.
In parents' school, they are abusing their classmates and. That's the reason of quarreling in the class, and here students' behavior is really impacted by one thing that I personally believe, that is by movies.
You see in movies, disrespecting teachers looks very cool. As you see the videos of Helvish Yadav.
Yes.
He makes very good videos. I really appreciate that guy has gone too much up. But the concern is this, the kind of videos he is making, he is giving kind of
negative
impact on the society, because kids think, yes, behaving like that is going to give me a lot of good thing. I will respect my teacher
I
will be cool. Desi na bola kar chori. So this is giving a very bad impact on the society.
Yeah, definitely.
I agree.
Okay, now we were upon the point.
Pius, give this mic to Pius.
Don't drag on the topic. Just come on the topic.
Please. Sir, I study class 4th in government school. Sir, I used to see the headmaster. The headmaster can sell rice and the pulses to the shopkeeper and make money from it. Mm-hmm. And teachers are not teachers are not capable of answering a little question, a small question, any questions. And also infrastructure is a main problem. And when government is not comparing to any colleges like IIT and IIMs, when the IIT people always want to go to IIM and they dream for it, and then why the public want they do not want to go to into public school as compared to the public colleges like IIT IIMs? Because of the government, and if the government run institute like IIT and IIMs, then single schools, how can they not able to run a single school in their state? If they build central universities like DU and JNU and other this, so the government are not involved in so properly, and teachers who are appointment before
the students who are studying in IIT, IIM and JNU and like these big colleges, the major reason is that they have to go through a competition exam.
Uh-huh.
And the top most students are going there.
Uh-huh.
So they are making their culture by himself. They are making that culture, and the teachers are more capable because they have also come by an exam. And like if we talk about government schools, these things are not happening. There is no competition. There is everyone should taking admission is very easy. Firstly, taking admission is very easy. Anyone can take admission. It's pocket friendly. Anyone can pay their fees of
the school. And the major thing why people are saying why those who are studying, because of midday meal which they provide, because of the scholarship, because of like the flexible hours. Like you have seen that students go in the government schools and come back after in the midday. They came back to the home. they do not study in like whole day. They come back home. So like taking admission, like this is pocket friend, that is pocket friendly, and if the parent is not that much capable to
I don't want to say that government run branch institutes like IIT and IIMs. So why
he government is also having private colleges, sir.
So they when they run IIM and IIT is like
so
that.
They are not able to run proper schools.
Proper schools,
yes, sir.
Yes,
this time the same.
I am giving the answer of the same thing.
Now you understand?
I have given the answer of the same thing. Like why the IIT, IIM and like these colleges are successful? Because the students who are studying there, they have gone through by a competitive exam. They are making their own environment, they are making their own culture.
If
a literate person, like
the listen, amount that is actually invested on that particular
thing,
that was invested by the government, not by the school. Basically, the amount that was invested by the government on that particular institute, that what we are talking about, IIM or learning and
development,
that was invested by the government, not by the students.
Yes.
And the same amount that was invested in the schools also.
Yes.
This is that not, but that
after
not
taking the admission, they are making the environment. But what about the infrastructure that was built by the government?
The major reason of this was, like ma'am have said earlier, that in government schools are every 1 kilometer. Like you go a kilometer to another kilometer, you will find another government school, and you are going to find there is only 7 IIM in the whole country.
If you calculate the amount invested on a single IIM.
Yes.
Now, if you calculate the schools that were made from that amount, it will be less than that IIM school.
Sir,
IIM college.
Currently,
thousands of schools in a city. If we calculate the amount which I invested in a city, that amount should be less than a lot less than that amount.
My brother got admission in DU BTech. Only for BTech in DU, 345 crore rupees is section for the only DU BTech branch. And they are 340 crores
for only
BTEC program.
Invested for what?
Only BTEC program.
Only for
BTEC program. Only for BTEC program in DU.
Invested for what?
BTEC program.
Only for BTEC
in DU.
For the infrastructure or for what?
All things. Because they introduced
for their practicality, for their lab, it could be anything.
One thing I mentioned, when you say that people are in IIM, they go through any admission,
yes.
But because comparing to primary labor, how can we those boys girls belongs from the villages?
No, that's not the question. The thing is, why that is, you say,
when the people get through in IIM, IIT, IIT,
you are saying that in a college like IIM, IIT, DU and
other branches
like JNU, EMU, I got your point. Like they are best colleges, and why schools are not best?
You don't understand, but you say that people are going into these colleges by exam. They go through exam
by
colleges, so exam. They take admission.
Yeah.
For comparing to primary level, the boys belong to villages, then does not know any little things from the family, like backward. People
I'm not
backward.
Saying that they have to give an exam for getting admission in a government college school.
Government is a big problem in the running.
That's what I am saying. The system is corrupt.
वही तो आए थे आई वही हमने तो वही कहा ना
The only the one basically
let me say one sentence. Yeah. The sentence that you are talking about that ma'am what ma'am spoke and what you are speaking and what even that Saurabh is trying to speak, what is the result?
Yeah.
What is the result? You are talking about only money or you are only talking about the only education? What is the result? For example, like he is in which school? You are studying private or government?
Private.
Tell me the name of your school.
RLB.
RLB. Yes. It's a private school. So you tell me. So are you really enjoying with your private school, or I think yes, you are in private school. You tell me like what things you need to find out, or what things you need to understand in a better way to if you are studying in private school. Sorry, private school. No, private. He is in private school.
Yes, I am private.
What good things you find in your school?
Good education.
Good education.
And there are many sports activity will held, and many competition will held. Like
only education matters.
No sir.
Only education.
Yes
sir. Only education.
Sir.
Agree.
Yes.
Only education matters. Firstly, you say I will give the answer to your question.
Sir, I have also.
Give this.
As both are say, why the colleges are good on their level, the government provided a lot of facilities. There is the one major reason, as he said, the students take their admission by cracking the competition. Yes, I am agree, totally agree with them. But there is also reason when the student is going at that stage, they are also capable to know their rights. If the government is not provide the proper facilities, the students and their one leader, one you, yes.
थोड़ा तो समझो, what kind of facilities?
Facilities like facilities like education related like.
Come to the next point. Education का
लॉक क्या है? Like infrastructures.
Infrastructure ठीक, okay fine, next.
And like scholarships, and syllabus regarding. Yes, sir. And different courses, courses, and
teacher faculty,
educated faculty. Yes, yes. And the teacher, those students are capable to know their rights, actual rights. If the government is not provided the facilities to them, then the one leader, like in every government college, like the UA leader, we can say, or UA Neta, they are able to strike against the facilities, their college authorities for their rights. And that's why maybe the reason is the government is providing good facility on their colleges.
I have studied in University of Allahabad. I have completed my graduation in BCom from University of Allahabad. I'll tell you about that university. First of all, I want to say that I got 90% marks in my graduation.
You're speaking like
Dhruv Rathke
now.
Yeah. So, I have given an exam in my first year. The first year was very good. I have given the exam, I got my result. In second year, the COVID came. What happened about the COVID? My college, the so-called University of Allahabad, not opened for the study purposes for 2 years. Some teachers have took the online classes. Like every private schools are opened after 6 to 8 months. Every private schools, they are taking the classes like online and offline in both medium.
Two session classes.
Yeah. But what happened in University of Allahabad, there are no classes. We have to join a coaching for our study. And if we talk about facilities, and like he is talking about UA Neta, and like Chhatra Adhyaksh, these things. University of Allahabad is famous for that thing, these things. There are a lot of Chhatra Neta and UA Chhatra Morcha and these kind of things. Mahamantri and like this. So they have protested a lot. They have attacked, they did the protest. and police, they got beaten by the police, but not a single action taken by the administrative of University of Allahabad. After 3 years, in 2022, till now, their courses are not on time. They are running 6 months late. Like their result, like if a person is passing their graduation in March 2023, then he is going to get their result in November 2023. He is late by 6 to 8 months till date. So like every government colleges are not that good. There are also corruptions in government colleges. If we leave the first class colleges like IIM, IIT, JNU, DU and AMU, these colleges, then we are going to find that some private schools, colleges are more better than
government. You understand the colleges and universities, some colleges are handled by the national government, and like the colleges that you are talking about, IIMs and like some colleges, they are handled by the central government.
Yes.
It
yeah.
depends who is handling. Yes, sir.
University of Allahabad is a central university.
Yes,
it is also handled by the central government.
Yes, sir, yes, agree. But I have also questions. As you can see, there are a lot of netas, like you give a lot of examples, but does not taken the action by the authorities of college or universities.
Yeah.
University. But there is also higher authorities established on India as compared to university authority. They are able to give application for other higher authority. They are strike. They use the social media platforms for their demand. If this is the central government, they directly send their message to central government by using the social media and a lot of things.
That's it.
And maybe it could be done.
Now let me speak. Like he is talking about, there are some other higher authorities than them. So. Firstly, University of Allahabad decisions taken by their vice chancellor itself, and a governing authority which we know like a UGC, University Grant Commission. So, like if they are issuing any decision, if they are giving any decision or if they are implementing anything, so that thing will be applicable for all colleges, like for government and private too. UGC, if UGC is giving any decision, so that thing is applicable for everyone. So that's not the thing. And like if we talk about education minister, they doesn't care what universities are doing, what they are doing, what they need. They only need money, in my opinion. I think my opinion is always
sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes. बॉम्ब मेकर बॉम्ब मेकर
बॉम्ब अच्छा बॉम्ब मेकर
चंद्रशेखर आजाद वाला
आल्सो बॉम्बर यस
यस
ओके
बट सर इन माय ओपिनियन इफ द स्टूडेंट्स एक्चुअल वांट टू डू समथिंग फॉर देयर कॉलेज दे एक्चुअल वांट बिगन से निकलवा लेंगे मींस व्हाट दे विल गेट इट फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट इफ दे एक्चुअल वांट इफ आई गिव यू एग्जांपल रिसेंट एग्जांपल ऑफ DDU. DDU means Dindal Upadhyay University from Gorakhpur. They already did it. If you don't know, then you find or search on Google and then you get a proper knowledge about it. On the behalf of your colleges, you don't just many more colleges. In my opinion, it's my personal opinion.
I remember there is a protest going on in University of Allahabad.
There was
a protest going on in University of Allahabad for a any vacancy of railway or something for which they are protesting in railway stations. They are blocking the railway tracks. It's almost
universities happens.
No. What happens? Like he is saying that if student want, then they are going to get that. I'll tell you a Group D vacancy. Railway key.
But I also used to tell only for facility of college, not for the
vacancy. I am living in Hindu Chhatravas at that time. So what happens? Students have blocked the railway track. Students have blocked the railway track.
And what police have did? A coach of railway has also burned by them. What police did? Police comes in the hostel, and like he beats the every single student who is living there. But why student went there? For the doing the protest, for getting what they want. Like you are saying, they are not getting.
I also disappointed. For the purpose, our
private schools are better than public schools or not? That's the point. So,
as you can see, sir, the students protest related by the purpose of job. It's a related of job, not the education. And in my opinion, I was always give the opinion related to education, and that's it.
Okay, I'll tell you.
My opinion is there. What I personally believe, schools do not matter. It totally depends on the student.
Yes, sir.
As Kabir has said,
school does matter.
Kabir Uttam
school does matter.
It totally depends on the student. I have seen the people who have studied from Lamarts, one of the named schools in Lucknow. The fee is like 1 lakh rupees per month for intermediate, and they are not doing anything. I have seen the people who have studied from the government school of Lucknow somewhere, and they are having very great life.
You just compare education. What about the moral values and ethics?
Okay, I'll compare the what are the major differences between private schools and government schools. I'll tell you why.
You are just comparing with money, with teacher, with faculties. What about changes your son and daughter will get after a certain period of time?
Firstly, why a person can study should go to the private schools, private colleges. I'll tell you why.
Example of your son, of your daughter, like whenever you will get married, what points or what things you will consider in your mind if you are going to take them to the
If somebody
I will never send my kid in the government school.
What will be the point?
The major reason is the society is not going to accept that thing because I want to be a millionaire. And if I am a millionaire and I am sending my kid into a government school, then society will say like that guy is earning in lakhs and sending his kid into a government school.
It sounds funny. Tell me some more reasons.
Because there is lack of infrastructure, like ma'am have already spoken. And there is the teachers are not that much capable. Every teachers are like almost.
Listen, people are not agreeing with you, but practically you are right. They all will do the same what you are saying.
Yes, sir.
They will not agree, but they will do it. They will never. Archer are not eligible.
No. Almost. Like if you go on YouTube and check out, there are thousands of videos are available where people are doing research, new channels are doing research that they are going with a mic and asking questions to the teachers.
They are skipping or they are just
giving the wrong answers. Some of the videos I have seen that they are not able to give the answer of Monday spelling. They did not know what are the months in a year.
The problem is here, the people who are going in that schools, they are not authorized, journalists. They don't have any license. You can be journalist. As you are able to speak good, you can speak louder also. This is one of the best qualities a journalist can have. So what you can do, you can just go on YouTube, create a channel, Saurabh News. And you take a mic in your
same setup,
you just enter any school. Who has given them right to ask the question to the teachers?
No.
The question is this: who the hell they are? The question is like advocate as we see. You cannot become advocate by wearing just a coat.
Yes, no, sir.
But nowadays, by having just one camera, one mic in your hand, and one iCard that you can get printed from anywhere, just it should be written, press over there, you are a certified. Society will accept you as a reporter. Or a journalist. And as you see, a lot of new channels are like that. Some personal reasons are there in the family and the guy is standing and aapko kaisa laga aapke bhai ko
but sir that's but that's not the point. I am saying that they are showing they are doing whatever.
They are showing only the negative parts so they can get viral on the internet. Why you are not seeing there are the teachers like her also?
Yes, sir.
She is also a government teacher. So there are teachers, there are many teachers are like that.
Teachers like her, these kind of examples are also available over YouTube.
And
also available.
When they pass one of the toughest examination in India, like not the toughest, but one of the toughest examination. Yeah. Yes, and yes. As you see, a lot of people are doing the preparation of that. And after that, they get selected. And they are appointed as a teacher. So, yes. And it is so hard. Means they have proven to the government and the society that they are capable of doing what they have been selected to.
Okay.
So, now. They are capable. There would be some examples. As you see,
okay.
If there is some bad, there would be some good also.
Yes,
sir. The teachers, like these examinations, like these, like what TET and Super TET, like CTET and these kind of examinations. CTET is just basically you can pass the examination with 33%.
As you are saying, it is very easy, na? You just crack one examination.
I will crack today CTET examination. It's just 33% marks required for the correct
practicing. Get a government job as a teacher.
I am coming on that point. Like you have said that it's tough to get a government job, government teacher job.
Yes.
It's what I think, like before 10 to 20 years, the teachers who got that job, the mostly teachers are appointed by the pradhans and these kind of, and like
earlier happened,
and like
20 years back.
I'll tell one more example, like in Sapa government, they have passed a rule that those persons who are working as a Shiksha Mitra, they will get a permanent job of government teachers. But there are also examples of like that. And Shiksha Mitra...
Not refused.
It's almost like...
It's a fact, sir.
Almost 60%
teachers are teaching on their
schools.
Yeah.
They are teaching. They are still teaching.
Only intermediate pass. And they were appointed by Ram
Panchayat.
Yeah. They are not capable to teach in these schools. I agree with you. But what can I do?
Yes,
what
yes,
can
sir.
We do? They are teaching still now.
Yes. They are still teaching, that's what I am saying.
And you are saying that Monday spelling and other questions, they were Shiksha Mitra. And there are 90% teachers who are capable for teaching.
That's nice. 6:32. Very nice. Clap for yourself, guys. Very nice.
I want to summarize.
Hope you enjoyed this.
Thank you.
So, guys, what do you support? As we are having a great discussion, we had a very great discussion over here about government schools and private schools. So, what's your opinion? Drop your comment in the comment box.
Subscribe, bolo channel.
Please subscribe.
Do subscribe.